welcomed you up here, but I would like to also welcome you here. We are glad you could be with us on this annual event, as a communication between all the parties represented here is so vital to effect positive change in our community.
The coalition members will use the dialogue that takes place today to address the expressed needs of our youth and form plans and meaningful activities for the following year. Fellow students, please take this opportunity to speak freely about your concerns and offer suggestions and solutions to the community leaders who have taken time from their busy schedules to be with you today.
Adults, please use this day for the rare opportunity to sit with the young people in your community and listen closely to their concerns and ideas.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Everybody excited?
Yeah.
Ready?
Yeah.
Enthused?
Yeah.
On fire? Anyway, I'm Pastor Ken. It's nice to have you all at Trinity again today. As has been mentioned, we've been the host site for Dialogue Day since its inception. We're always thrilled to do that. So glad to have you all here.
Really impressive that you are here and taking positive steps. And we recognize and we're so proud to support your organization because we recognize and unfortunately we see the results, the negative results of things like drug use, criminal behavior, bad choices. We see the end game of that. And it's so nice to be in a place where you guys are trying to get out in front of it and to stop it, not just for yourselves, but for the kids sitting next to you, for the friends you see in class, for your neighbors. It's really important. The power of this group, I think, really is community-driven, and we appreciate that. And thank you guys so much for letting us be a part of it.
Drug addict, an alcoholic, all of the above, and I'm in recovery. And I know I get a lot of looks like that. Choose a word to describe the way I was brought up. Normal, I guess, would fit best. Two-parent household, middle-class family with two younger sisters. I told the groups that I was a part of, or at least one earlier, I didn't get good grades. I got exceptional grades. I didn't play sports well. I played exceptionally in sports. And it was, that classic American family upbringing. And somewhere along the line, the path of normalcy that I was on deviated into one of addiction, alcoholism, drug abuse, stuff like that. And it was very difficult for me to see at the time how or why or exactly what was going on. And it's easier for me to look back now and kind of piece it together.
I'm a facilitator at Dialogue Day for 2014. Here, when we do Dialogue Day, it's all about getting communication between the students and young people of the area and getting communication with them and the business leaders, maybe people who don't really communicate with the kids, or judges, or teachers, or administrators, and stuff like that. They don't really get direct communication with the kids all the time. So now is the time for the adults to listen to the kids and see what their problems are, hear their voice. And that's what Dialogue Day is all about. And facilitators, they keep the conversation going. I was trying to keep us on topic. I was doing family interactions and stuff about at home. And I was just trying to keep the conversation on par. And I didn't want the adults to talk too much because I wanted the kids to really be able to have their voice heard. So I've been doing Dialogue Day for 6 years. I've been on the Community Action Coalition for the same amount of time. I've been doing this ever since 7th grade, and now I'm a senior. This has been really interesting. Doing Dialogue Day, it really opened my eyes up to, like, wow, the adults really do want to listen, and they really do, because I hear this all the time. I'm around kids all the time, and just hearing, hearing what the adults have to say about it and hearing what they feel once they hear about the information from the kids and the way their lives are and what's going on with them and their struggles and not just judging them. I hope that the kids who were in the sessions today, they feel like they can be more supportive. Like, they feel like they have a better support group. They feel like they have somebody to just talk to, that they can always go to somebody to talk to, that people are going to listen. I hope they feel that they're not as closed off as they did before they came to Dialogue Day today.
The group had youth involvement and activities, and I'm going to switch the slide with that. Okay, so main problems or concerns in this area is that going through high school and life, you build a lot of connections. And the thing was, we wanted to make sure everyone built the right connections and got to know the right people and got involved in the school as much as they could. Also, influence. In many different situations, there's leaders and there's followers. And then there's also, not only in like a specific organization, there's leaders everywhere, just in a classroom. And we wanted to let people know that you can influence people. You have a big influence on people. And just talking to someone, you can have a big impact on other people's lives.
I was in charge of bullying, and we had a great session. I felt like everyone in the room connected with each other at some point or another. What we decided about bullying is that bullying has changed. Bullying's not the same that it used to be. Bullying is a different level now that you adults don't understand, because bullying goes on behind screens now. There's no face to bullying. There's no someone that walks up to you and pushes you in the garbage can anymore. No, it's these bullies that are online. They don't have a face. They don't have a name. They're the anonymous. They're the people that put you down and you can't even stand up for yourself. They're the people that break you down inside and you have nowhere, no one to direct your anger towards. But what we talk more about bullying is that there are ways to stop it. And our Now Whats include assemblies and inspiration.
So every year we have a dialogue day, and we take all the feedback and the reporting out information that we just shared, and we take that as our coalition and go through it and talk about, okay, these are the issues, this is what's going on, this is what we heard at dialogue day, now what can we do with it? What can be our new goals and our new mission for a coalition for the upcoming school year? So just so you know, that's how we got all those accomplishments, and we're looking forward to many, many more of those with the help of all of you here today. So I want to thank you for that.
It amazes me every year when I come to dialogue day to have an opportunity to talk to the students and get their ideas on things. They are a very mature group of individuals. Their enthusiasm and their ideas are wonderful. It gives us new ideas to think about. They're truthful, and they just amaze me with their abilities. It was really interesting. I think the best thing is just knowing that our future is in good hands. A lot of people think that education is broken and that our future is not going to be as good as it has been in the past, but I'm convinced that we are in good hands, and that this generation is going to take us to greater depths than we've ever seen in the past.